the final in the Bronx, Red Sox winning it 4-3. We've heard the term the agony of defeat mentioned a lot of times in the history of sports. And you look at this one as the Yankees rallied with two in the ninth, but they came up just short.
Well, they came up just short. They had an amazing season. But this series comes down to the fact that they scored four runs in two games at Yankee Stadium. And you got to say they scored two runs in the bottom of the ninth because Kimbrel was all over the place and tried to give it to them. They battled to the end, but at the end, it's going to be disappointing because the bats really didn't show up. Some questionable moves by Aaron Boone in this series. Alex Cora had a great series going all in with Sale and Kimbrel at the end.
Yeah, pulsating finish for the Yankees. As you said, they get a couple of runs in the ninth inning. They give their fans one last gasp of hope. But in the end, they lose two games at home. And as you said, John, only four runs. This is a team that set the all-time home run record. They did not hit a home run in the last two games at home. They dominated at home this year. Second best record in the major leagues, but the Red Sox thoroughly outplayed them. And John, you hinted at it. A lot of the questions about tonight's game will be Aaron Boone staying with CC Sabathia too long. This is a do or die game. Boone himself talked about how you have to have someone ready at a moment's notice, and Boone did not do that. When CC had trouble in the third inning, it was a few batters too late to finally replace him.
Yeah, we're waiting for that sense of urgency, right? Benintendi gets hit, and we're all watching it saying, who's warming up in the bullpen? And it just happened late. Aaron Boone seemed like he was a little late. And then on the flip side, Alex Cora gets five out of Porcello, and he goes to the bullpen and gets some good outings from some guys who have been a little shaky. Barnes, Brazier, they get it done, and then he gets aggressive with Sale. Kimbrel obviously is shaky, but he gets a job done. But I thought Aaron Boone in this game, we talked about going to your guys early. You got to have a sense of urgency. I thought a little bit late with Sabathia in there, and he gave up some runs in the third.
And give a little context to it. John mentioned Benintendi getting hit. When he got hit by a pitch, that was the fifth base runner against CeCe in the first 11 batters. There was a lot of traffic on the bases, so it wasn't as if CeCe had earned a longer leash at that point. And it never hurts to get somebody up. CeCe could have gotten a double play ground ball right there, and you have the reliever sit down. But he did not get David Robertson up until there were two outs in the inning, and the Red Sox had a 1-0 lead. Robertson wasn't ready. Two guys, the next two hitters come through with run scoring hits against CeCe, and suddenly 1-0 is 3-0. And the way the Yankee offense was performing, it felt like a lot larger than 3-0.
It makes me think of what you said prior to game three, and that's that you thought he would manage it like a wild card game. Yep. So if that's the case, you get some traffic on the bases, it's a 1-0 game, why not go to a David Robertson, have him hot, have him ready to go?
As Jack said, just have him ready to go. Have the option if you want to go to him. Everything developed really, really slowly for Aaron Boone, getting his bullpen guys ready. It got away from Sabathia a little bit, and you just felt like you said, with the way the Yankees have been swinging the bats the last 2 days, that three-run deficit was huge at the beginning of the game.